हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, आई एम राजमुख सहर, लेक्चर ऑन बिजनेस स्टडीज, विश्वमनोपी कॉलेज, चित्रदुर्ग। सो डियर स्टूडेंट, इन लास्ट वीडियोस वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग एज वेल एज वी आल्सो हैव सीन अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस एंड लिमिटेशंस ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग। टुडे आई एम हियर टू एक्सप्लेन वन मोर इम्पोर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग इज कॉल्ड प्रोसेस ऑफ कंट्रोलिंग और कंट्रोलिंग प्रोसेस। ओके, again this question is asked for the 5 marks and it will be also asked for the 4 marks question. Okay, it is very important question from the point of your examination. Okay, so as you know that controlling is a process of comparing the actual performance with the predetermined plans or with the set standards. Okay, by comparing your actual or current performance with the predetermined plans, you will come to know about the deviation. You will with the help of comparison, you come to know about the result. Okay, whether you are according to your predetermined plans or you are deviating from the plans. Okay, in order to check that, comparison is made. So actual performance with the standard performance you are going to compare. This comparison this comparison reveals the deviation. Okay, if the performance are matching with your pre standards, okay, your set standard, then there is nothing to control. Okay, if the performance is below or above the standards whatever you have set, then there is a need of corrective measures. That is what the controlling. Okay, now let us discuss about the process of controlling or steps involved in a controlling process one by one. The first one is setting. The first step under controlling is performance standard. Setting up of a performance standard. The setting up of a performance standard could be the first step under controlling process. This performance standard will act as a criteria against which your actual performance or your present performance or your current performance will be measured. Could be measured or compared. Okay, that is what a performance standard. Setting up of performance standard is nothing but this performance standard will act as a base against which your current performance or present performance is going to be compared. Okay, this performance standard act as a benchmark. It serves as a benchmark towards which organization strive to work, towards which the organization willing to work. That is what a performance standard. So this performance standard becomes a basis for the comparison, and even the manager strive to follow the standard. Okay, that is what a performance standard. This performance standard can be set in two both the terms. One is quantitative terms and another one is qualitative terms. Okay, for instance, when you are setting your standard in quantitative terms, like in terms of cost to be incurred, revenue to earn, number of product to be produced, okay, and number of unit to be sold, that all comes under your quantitative, that is what quantitative terms. Okay, when your standards are set in a quantitative terms, that could be measured easily and that could be count easily. Okay, the comparison will become easy when it is in terms of quantity. Okay, even the standards can be set in a qualitative terms. Okay, that is what a qualitative terms. In terms of quantitative, improve of your goodwill of the company should be improved. Okay, and even motivation level of the employees have to improve, the morale of the employee have to improve. This all comes under the quantitative terms. Okay, so while setting the standard, the manager should set those standard in a precise manner as much as possible. Okay, by having objective, he is going to set this performance standard. Okay, this performance standard should permit to adopt the changes in whatever happening in the business and organization. Okay, in order to meet with the reality, in order to cope up with the existing environment and existing business, this standard should permit the flexibility. Okay, the standard should be flexible so that modification can be intake, modification can be adopted, okay, in that standard to become a reality, or in order to meet with the, or in order to cope up with the existing environment or existing situation. Okay, that is what a performance standard. The performance standard is nothing but it act as a, this performance standard will act as a benchmark, okay, against which organization strive to work. This performance standards can be set in both the terms, one is quantitative, another one is qualitative. Quantitative means what? Quantitative means what? Which can be caught and which can be measured, like number of unit that have to produce, 10, 20, like that, okay? And even the time spent in performance of a particular task. In order to complete a particular task, how much time I'm going to consume? That is what is a key. We can easily measure it, okay? That is what a quantitative. Whereas in a quantitative, this performance standard can also be set in a quantitative terms, like goodwill have to improve, goodwill of the company have to be improved, okay? Motivation level of the employee, we cannot measure it easily. But manager has to pay attention while setting these standards. Okay, he has to pay, he has to set those standards precisely. Okay, okay, where you can easily compare and you can easily measure it. Okay, for instance, when it comes to the comparison of your quantitative terms, okay, take for example, how they are going to set means the take consumer satisfaction. Okay, the number of time he takes in order to order for supply, okay, order, okay, order the ordering, okay, the time he spent on the counter, or that is on the table, okay, or the time he took to get his order back. That is what, likewise, we are going to compare our quantitative standards. Okay, that is, this standard should be flexible so that you can easily modify your standards, so that you can easily match, or you can easily cope up with the changes, or you can in reality you can attain your set standards. Okay, this standard should be flexible. That is what a performance standard, setting of performance standard. Next is, so the next step under your controlling process is, process of controlling is measurement of actual performance. Once the performance standard has, the next step under controlling process is measurement of actual performance. So once the performance standard has been set, the next step involved under process, controlling process is actual performance, measurement of actual performance. The performance can be measured with objectively and in a reliable manner. The performance of individual should be measured objectively and reliable manner, okay, accurately, without any bias. You have to measure, you have to evaluate the performance of the individual. So measurement of actual performance is nothing but the performance of the employee should be measured with the objective and with the reliable manner, okay, accurately, and there should be no subjectivity, there should be no bias, there should be no differentiation while evaluating the performance of an individual. The performance evaluation of an individual includes, okay, the techniques of measurement includes, okay, personal observation, the next is sample checking and performance report, etc. are used to evaluate the performance of the individual. Okay, so the technique includes like personal observation. Okay, by having continuous monitoring, you are going to check the work of the individual. That is called personal observation. Next is sample checking. Sample means what? Randomly you are going to select and you are going to check. Okay, to check the performance of the individual. That is what sample checking and performance report. Okay. By checking the report of an individual, you are going to evaluate the performance of an individual. Okay, so the performance of an individual should be checked should be measured objectively and reliable manner accurately without any discrimination. You have to evaluate the individual. Okay, the techniques like personal observation, sample checking and performance report. Okay, as far as possible, the measurement of performance should be done on a same term, okay, which you have set, which you have established your standards. Okay, in same unit, whatever the standards you have set in the unit, with the same unit you have to compare. Okay, for example, if you have set the standards for the marketing, those standards you are using to evaluate the performance of another unit, like you are checking the performance of R&D, this evaluation will give you no meaning. But instead, you have to use those standards in the same unit in order to compare, in order to easily compare. You can use the same standard in a same unit. Okay, as you know that the performance measurement of performance could be done after the completion of your task, but as much as possible the measurement could be done while operating your task. Okay, while performing the task you can compare. For instance, okay, while assembling your products, okay, assembling products, okay, before the assembling of your goods and assembling of your product, you have to check the each product produced, okay, then you can assemble. Okay, in case of manufacturing industries, okay, you have to check, you can monitor the gas particles available in the air in order to assure, in order to maintain the safety. Likewise, in a marketing, The standards could be measured, okay, like number of goods to be sold, okay, market share has been increased. Likewise, you can measure the actual performance. Like in a market, the number of unit to be sold in a month is 1,000 rupees, but actually how much you have sold. Okay, if you have set the standard is 1,000, but you have sold only 800, then there will be a differences. There will be a variation. That variation can be analyzed and you can come up with the solution. Likewise, if the standards are in the quantity terms, you can easily compare and you can easily make a decision. That is what a measurement of actual performance. Next one is, the third is comparing the actual performance with the standard. Okay, the first is the standard you have set. The next one is you are measuring the actual performance, correct performance you are going to measure, you are going to evaluate. Now you are making the comparison between the actual performance with the standards. Okay, whatever the standards you have set and whatever the performance you are now currently you are performing, though both the performance are going to be compared. By comparing the actual performance with the standard performance, when you are comparing, the result is going to be depicted. This comparison will reveal the deviations, whether you are up to the mark of your standard or you are going below the standards, or you are going above your standards. Okay, this will reveal the deviations. Okay, the comparison of your actual performance with the standard, such comparison will reveal the deviation. Comparison will become easy when the standards set in a quantitative terms. Say for example, in a production or manufacturing unit, okay, individual, say for example, employee called A, Mr. A, he has to produce the goods, produce the unit is 60 unit he has to produce in a week. In a week, he has to produce 60 unit. But Mr. A has produced only 40 units in a week. Only 40 units in a week. Okay. So here the actual performance and the standard performance is going to be measured. Okay. By measuring this, still 20 unit, okay, he has not produced. Okay, he is not up to the mark of the standard. Okay. This comparison will reveal the deviation. Why this deviation is going to be analyzed, that is in a next step. Okay, analysis of your deviation. Next is analysis of deviation. The fourth step under your controlling process is analysis of deviation. So in third step, you come to know about the deviation, that is what 20% differences you are getting. Okay, 20 units the difference you are getting when compare your actual performance with the standard. This is what the standard. In standard, you have set is 60 unit a individual has to produce in a week. But actually, how much he has produced? Only 40 unit he has produced. But the variation after comparing this, we come to know about the result. The result is 20% off. He did not produce 20% unit. Okay, 20 units he has not produced. The fourth step is what your analysis of deviation. Why we did not produce? Why he did not match up? Why he did not cope up with our standard? Why did not he follow the standards? That is what, in order to analyze the problem, in order to know the reason behind not producing, that analysis is essential. Okay, so this analysis of deviation, the studying about your problem in depth, okay, that this stuff is considered. Okay, some deviation in the performance in almost all the activities should be acceptable. Okay, there will be a little bit changes can be accepted, but if the changes is huge, that is not that should not be accepted by the management. Okay, so it is therefore important for the manager to determine, okay, to give the acceptable range of deviation. Okay, the acceptable range of deviation, how much deviation can be accepted, okay, which is right, which is considered to be okay. Okay, that need to be determined. Say for example, we have said 60 unit to be produced, okay, in a week, but if he produced 59 58, that is okay. Okay, that is no much to be concentrated. Okay, but if he produce 50 40 20, like that, then you need to pay much attention. Okay, likewise here it is important for the manager to determine the acceptable range of deviation, and even the deviation in the key result areas, that is what important areas. Okay, you have how much deviation is accepted in this area, and attention is needed urgently in this area than compared to your inefficient, insignificant areas. Okay, that is why management is going to use two technique called control, critical point control, and management by exception. These two techniques are used by the management in order to analyze the deviation. Under critical, the technique uses critical point control, and last one is management by exception. These two techniques, exception. Okay, analysis of deviation, in order to analyze the deviation, in order to set the acceptable range of deviation, the managers are going to use two techniques in this regard. First one is critical point control, and the management by exception. Under critical point, what happened? So it is not permissible, it is not easy, it is not economic to measure each and every activity. To evaluate each and every activity is not so easy, it is not economical. Therefore, you have to measure those area which is significant for the success of the organization, which is important for the organization. Those activity, those critical point only you have to control. That says about your critical point control. So in critical point, what they are saying, everything you are not going to control. Okay, it is not economical, it is not easy to control each and every activity, each and every performance in the organization you cannot control. But you have to control only those area, only those key result areas, only those you have to look out, only those areas which is significant for you, which is essential for the success of the organization, which the area which affect the performance of the organization, only those area you have to give much concentration. You have to solve the problems of key result areas which affect the success or existence of the organization. That is what critical point control will say. Say for example, if there is an increase in the labor cost by 5%, and increase in postal charge by 20% or 15%. Okay, increase in labor cost, increase in postal charge. Okay, under your critical control, If the labor cost is increased by 5% and the postal charges increased by 20%, here the manager will pay much attention on the 5%, okay, not on the postal charge by 20%. Though it has been increased by 20%, they give much importance for the 5% because your postal charges will be less compared to your labor charges. Labor cost will be in 1000, whereas your postal charges will be in 100. So here the labor cost will affect the organization more than your postal charges. Okay, here the key area, the significant area is going to be controlled. They are going come up with the solution, okay, but they will ignore your insignificant areas. That is what critical point analysis. Next is management by exception. Another technique is management by exception. So management by exception is another very important principles of management. It is also refer as a control by exception. This says that control everything result in controlling nothing. Okay, if you are going to control everything, but you will not going to control anything. Okay, that is why this says that this believes the management by exception believes that only the major deviation, only those deviation which goes beyond a permissible limit or which goes beyond the acceptable limit, only those deviation should be brought into the notice of the management, which needs the immediate action, which is remedial measure. Only those deviation should be brought to the notice of the management. Okay, insignificant deviation should be ignored. That is what a management by exception. So analysis of deviation is nothing but you have to set, the manager has to determine the acceptable range of deviation and the deviation in the key areas where most urgent measures is needed. Okay, most attention need to be paid in those areas. So in order to measure the deviation, in order to analyze the deviation, manager are going to use critical point control and management by exception. Critical point area, what they will say, only the critical path, only the critical point key area result, so key result area you need to pay much attention and remaining you have to be ignored. In management by exception, what they will say that it believes that management by exception believes that so only those deviation you have to brought to the notice of the management which will affect the performance. Okay, but the remaining what we can say, the deviation which is insignificant, that should be ignored. Last step under your controlling performance is corrective action, taking corrective measures or remedial actions. Okay, so the final step under your controlling process is remedial measures. So here no corrective measures is required when your deviations under the permissible limits, under the acceptable limits, there is no need of corrective measures. If the deviations are major, okay, if the deviations are beyond the permissible limits, then this needs a corrective action. So nothing but if you are producing 58 units in a week, then there is no need of corrective measures. If it is going beyond the permissible limits, which is not acceptable, like producing 40 units, then the manager needs to pay much attention in order to correct, in order to meet the standards. Okay, so the standards. So this corrective measures involved or corrective action involves like training of an employee if he did not meet with the standards in a production unit. Okay, if suppose he did not produce the according to the standards, then the trainee is needed for the employee. Okay, similarly, in order to complete, if the project, whatever the project we have undertaken, if we are not completing within a given time, within a schedule, then we need to recruit the more employees, or we should ask the employees for the overtime work we have to ask. This is in case the deviation is not if the deviation is not eliminated with the help of the management solutions, with the help of the managerial action, then the standards have to be revised. Okay, whatever the standard you have set, that once you have to revise, that is what the corrective action. Corrective action is nothing but no corrective action is required, no correction is required if the deviations is under the limits, under the framework of your standard. Okay, under the permissible limits, then there is no need of corrective action, there is no need of remedial measures. If goes the deviation is major, it is a significant for the success of the organization, then the manager need to pay attention, okay, to those deviations. Okay, he has to take the corrective measures. Okay, so the actions, like the corrective actions, like training to the employee, giving training and development to that employee so that he can achieve the target whatever we have set, and even asking the employee for the overtime work, okay, if you are not meeting the particular project within a time, and even recruiting the new employees, that is what we can, that corrective action we can take. By taking all these measures, if you are not meeting our expectations, then the standards whatever you have set, that has to be revised. That is what the corrective action. Next is techniques of managerial control. So the various techniques are tools used by the manager in an organization to exercise the controlling function. Okay. So these techniques of managerial control has been categorized into two types. One is into two categories. One is traditional techniques, another one is modern techniques. The traditional techniques are those techniques which have been used by the companies for a long time now. These traditional techniques have not become outdated, they have not become obsoleted, but still, and they are still being used by the many companies, being used by the many organizations. This traditional technique includes personal observation. The traditional techniques like personal observation, statistical report, okay, statistical reports like your time series, regression analysis, statistical report, graphs, okay, that all being used by the organization. Next is budgetary control. And the last one is break-even analysis. The techniques, the tools being used under your traditional techniques of managerial control is personal observation, statistical report, budgetary control, and break-even analysis. This comes under your traditional techniques of managerial control. The next one is modern techniques. Modern techniques of control are those which are new in the management literature. Okay, these are new in a managerial techniques, or even you can say sophisticated techniques of managerial control. Okay, the managerial techniques, modern techniques of control is those techniques which are new thinking. Okay, these techniques provide a new thinking or new ways of controlling the activities in the organization. So the modern techniques involve return on investment. The next is auditing, management audit. Okay, management audit, social responsibility. Okay, social responsibility accounting. PERT and critical path analysis. PERT and CPA and ratio analysis. These are the techniques which is used under modern technique. The first one is return on investment, management audit, accounting, responsibility accounting, PERT, performance review, evaluation review technique, and critical path analysis and the ratio analysis. These are the modern techniques of control.
So here are the assignment questions. So first assignment question for the homework is define controlling. You have to give the definition of controlling. Next is explain the process of controlling, the steps involved in the process, controlling process, that is the 5 steps. First is performance setting, performance standard, measuring actual performance. The next one is comparison of actual performance with the standards, deviation, okay, analysis of deviation. Now the last one is remedial measure or corrective action. That is what the 5 steps you have to explain in detail. Next is mention the modern techniques of controlling. So here modern techniques of controlling like return on investment, ratio analysis, responsibility accounting, management audit, PERT, PART and CPM, critical path management or critical path analysis, and program evaluation review technique. That you have to be that you have to mention here. And the last one is management information system. Okay, these are the modern technique that you have to explain here. Okay, so we will discuss the techniques of managerial control in detail in the next video. Thank you.